Welcome to Comedians Interviewing Musicians. You're listening to the audio version of the live streaming podcast from Austin, Texas. This is season 4, episode 56, recorded on September 25th, 2018, live from Austin Eastciders Collaboratory with hosts BeckiJo Neill and Claude Ramey. Our musical guest is Superfónicos. But first, we have a not-so-secret little club to tell you about, where you can get access to exclusive content, merch, your own spotlight on the show, and of course more for as little as $1 a month. Join our community of patrons that make this show so possible. Sign up at cimp.live. That's cimp.live. Thank you for supporting live music. And remember, give the podcast a 5-star rating. Every rating helps these artists get discovered by new fans. And now, brought to you by Music Firsthand and their live music booking app, here's Comedians Interviewing Musicians.
Thanks so much for joining us tonight at Austin Eastciders. Give a round of applause to Eastciders for hosting us. They are always awesome. Give it up to them.
Austin Eastciders.
Thank you. We love you. We've got a really special show here tonight because, well, one, the guests, but two, it's also Sean's. Who's Sean?
I don't know.
Who is Sean? Who is Sean? It's Claude's last show with us.
It's my last show.
Why did we have like a soundboard? Wah, wah.
Wah, wah, wah. No. I don't know. We've got like 17 musicians on the stage,
I know.
But whatever.
Well, here, cheers to you, doll. We love you.
Thank you. We're going to start
this one good off, right? Would you like to introduce our beautiful musical guests?
I would love to introduce our beautiful, interesting new... I forgot what all the adjectives you used. Anyways, I would love to introduce our group tonight, our artists. Please give it up for Superfónicos.
Llego a tu puerta golpeando el miedo sin compasión. Oye, morena, llego a tu puerta golpeando el miedo sin compasión. Dándome helado de toda tu alma y puesto celoso a tu corazón. Se ha apoderado de toda tu alma y puesto celoso a tu corazón. Ahí vino el miedo y allá profundo dentro de mis sueños ya se metió. Ahí vino el miedo y allá profundo dentro de mis sueños ya se metió. Yo quería ser el mejor gaitero, pero es que el miedo me congeló. Yo quería ser el mejor gaitero, pero es que el miedo me congeló. No tengas miedo, no. Que el miedo mata, sí. No tengas miedo, no, que el miedo mata.
Thank you.
cierto miedo, el mismo demonio, con garras firmes y buen talón. Maldito miedo, el mismo demonio, con garras firmes y buen talón. Tan elegante que hay quien lo viera, nadie sabría que es un timador. Tan elegante que hay quien lo viera, nadie sabría que es un timador. El pueblo entero seguía sentado con mucho miedo y poco valor. El pueblo entero seguía sentado con mucho miedo y poco valor, pero se armaron con toda vaina, gaitas, tambores y una canción. Pero se armaron con toda vaina, gaitas, tambores y una canción. No tengas miedo, no, que el miedo mata, sí. No tengas miedo, no, que el miedo mata, sí. No tengas miedo, no, que el miedo mata, sí. No tengas miedo, no, que el miedo mata.
Keep it going for Superfónicos. Woo! That was dope. Thank you guys so much for being here. It's really awesome. I feel like I'm talking to like
Thanks
a whole class.
I know, yeah.
All right. do you guys want to introduce yourselves or tell us who you are?
My name is Jaime Ospina. We're Superfónicos.
Oh, okay.
All right.
That was a good joke. And I don't even try.
So your guys' sound on your website is, you call yourself, it's Afro-Colombian rhythms. Then also in your bio, it said something deeply rooted in Caribbean flavor. I think, like, obviously everyone can tell that now, but do you want to talk about, like, your journey with this style of music and, how, like, I guess why it's important for y'all to play this kind of music?
Well, it's just it's a different music from any other Latin American music, the Colombian music. So, and we have that treasure there, and it's beautiful. So we just like bring it and just like share it with the community, because everybody has like an idea of what is to be Latino, but there are like 100 ways to be Latino, and one of that ways is Colombian.
That's like that's a song. 100 ways to be Latino. No, that's gorgeous. Where does Superfónicos come from? Like, where does the name come from? Ooh, it's like in the back.
He's Andres Villegas, he's the guitar player. One of the guitar players.
Super. Eddie.
Wait, it's stupid?
Super. Oh. Not well, stupid. Well, we had a lot of stupid names before for about over a year, for sure.
What were some of the old
band
names?
Phonicos, which, phonics, which is sound.
Sound, yeah.
So we wanted a big sound.
What were some of the stupid names? That's more interesting.
Yeah, I
want
to know the stupid names.
Probably the stupidest song we had was Los Zapatos.
Yes. Okay.
The shoes, for those that don't speak Spanish.
It's like Spanish 101,
Claude.
That
sounds so exotic.
No, the shoes. Any other, but like, that was a song title or a band name? Band name?
I think we just looked at our shoes and we're like, man, we need a name.
Well, didn't someone make a whole movie about that? And
I mean,
it was like
there was
a
band called The Doors. I don't know if you've heard
the
of
shoes,
them.
The Shoes, The Doors. It's all one thing. I guess you guys are going to play ACL soon, right? Like in a month, about a month, almost a month. How far away is that now? What year is it?
A couple weeks.
Yeah, a couple weeks.
October 14th.
A couple weeks, to answer your question.
Days, a number of days. Are you guys excited? Have you played ACL before?
No, this will be our first time, so yeah, we're pretty pumped about
it. Pretty stoked. What are you most excited for?
Well, it's pretty cool to be on a bill with Paul McCartney.
There we go.
Yeah.
That's cool.
That's true. The bragging rights. We're like, I play with Paul McCartney. Do you guys have any, like, festival hacks, ACL festival hacks for anybody? Any, like, festivals you've been to where you learned something on, like, maybe just touring? You want to give knowledge to the world?
I do. I am looking forward to, I think, in the artist lounge, they have a gilded toilet.
What?
Which, if you've been to any festival, the restrooms are pretty gnarly. So.
Yeah.
Gilded toilet.
Gilded, so it's like gold-plated?
I believe so. I don't know. I'm going to find out. I believe
like
it is.
Going to search all of the festival
like
for the
golden
toilet. They're
like telling you it's gold-plated, yeah.
It's all a lie. do you guys have any, like, not musical inventions, but like your favorite musical instrument that's ever been invented, hands down?
Yeah, he invented it.
What? You invented something?
Yes.
Well, we don't have it here, so there's no show and tell available.
This is a native Colombian flute. You can see it's very different. It's long as hell. And it has like a beeswax charcoal kind of like head. And this is, they created this like thousands of years ago in Caribbean coast in Colombia. And then this technology of like creating the sound has been kind of like evolved. And now I have a flute that has this mouthpiece, but it has the body of a like silver,
what?
European Western flute. So it's like
the $1 million flute. They can rebuild.
Is that awesome. Going to make an appearance in a song later, or are you just teasing us with it?
I mean, I left it somewhere. I gotta go check. It.
It's somewhere. It's murping around somewhere.
Sure? Oh, that's not it.
No. He said he didn't bring it.
Oh, okay. I see.
If you could invent another hybrid instrument, what would it be, though? Like, we're going, like, jazz, bagpipes.
I mean, they already have... That. Melodicas, honestly, always kind of creep me out because they look like piano fetuses.
What? Piano fetuses?
Yeah, I can't unsee it now.
That's too much, Claude. You're
sorry.
Gonna choose piano
fetuses.
It's
my last day. I'm just calling it like I see it.
He's going rogue. He's going off the handles. Oh, I think we're trying to find the cool flute. I don't know. We went on a tangent. This is our
I mean, I thought what we saw was a pretty cool flute already. That's.
It was a cool flute. So there's eight of you. Oh.
There's seven now.
This is like the best game of Lost and Found. Right. Do you guys want to... I was like, we're going to play another song, but he's coming back up here. There's eight of y'all. What is the hardest part about like writing, recording, getting together? Is it just literally getting all of you together?
That's the hardest part, is just coordinating anything.
Y'all are just like all busy. Ooh. We got it.
All right. We found the super flute.
The super flute. Oh. I'm like actually super excited. I mean, I'm sweating out of anticipation and also because it's hot as shit.
So I noticed a lot like a commitment to patterns.
I was going to say, you guys are very festive.
Did that start with like a natural style or did you decide like, nah, we're going to do like pattern shirts. It's going to be our thing.
I think it was kind of an unconscious decision. We're like, how do we stand out? We're
the
like,
guy in the solid shirt went second one. Yeah.
It's like no one told me. Is it just like, did it just happen? You guys all just have like very vibrant wardrobes?
I mean, sometimes we totally clash, so.
Oh, okay.
This is a whole production.
Sometimes we're coordinated. Wow.
Eventually, we will get back to music. But this is almost too much fun. It's like the Frankenflute.
Maybe we should have a challenge where you build a new instrument on the spot.
On
the
like
show.
Timed?
Yeah.
Yes! We have to make it a competition.
Except the comedians
as per usual.
Have to build the instrument.
There we go.
This is going to be end terribly.
While he's grabbing the mouthpiece, you guys are the Austin Music Foundation's Artist of the Month.
Artist of the Month.
This
yeah.
month? Yeah, give it up for them. That's pretty freaking cool. Yeah. Have you been in there? It's like the coolest, like weird New York flat studio something thing just converted into like a hang. That's like the coolest thing. Are you going to get like your record on the wall and everything?
Yeah.
Oh, that's fancy. That's fancy. Do you get to play a show there? Like, I'm not familiar with how the Artist of the Month works. How does that work?
Do we?
We have a representative here from Austin Music Foundation, Emily over here.
Howdy, howdy.
Give it up for
hello
Emily.
To Emily.
Austin Music Foundation. They've hosted some of our shows.
Do you guys want to play another song? Yes. Yay! All right. No, please. I really wanted to see the super flute, but it's chill. How about Austin Eastciders give it up for Superfónicos?
Mm-hmm.
gilded and stabbed it with face.
Exciting. Thank you guys so much for coming out. Again, Facebook, if you have questions, please feel free to submit them at the bottom of the comment section. We will read them, maybe even ask them.
That's what we're doing when we're checking our phones. We're not being rude.
We're not on Tinder. Now. Right now. It's fine. Thank you so much for joining us again. We love you so much. You guys just, I saw on your Instagram, you guys got put on the Latinx indie playlist on Spotify.
Yeah.
Is that like the coolest thing or the coolest thing ever?
That's pretty cool.
Like, what did you, did they tell you? How does that work? They send you, like, a text? Like, hey, we're going to put
you. They don't really
stuff.
Tell you.
That's weird.
You just, your numbers go up, and you're like, what's going on?
Oh.
And
we
you're
went
like,
viral.
Thank you, Spotify.
That's pretty dope. So there's someone on Spotify who's just out there, like, hunting down.
They,
that's
yeah,
pretty
they're
dope.
Making playlists.
Giving up for awesome. Spotify. Hmm. And you guys have a music video coming out soon, correct? You just finished shooting it?
Yeah, it's actually probably getting edited as we speak.
Ooh, I like that. Timely. Yeah. Was anybody like a huge, who's the biggest diva on set? Anybody?
Definitely oh. Nick.
Oh!
Two opposing pointer fingers.
Some wow. Tension. Let's unpack that. Okay, so what happened?
What happened?
I just want to know.
No, it was really chill. We recorded like a live set and then just did some shots of us kind of yelling, so...
Sounds
really
normal.
Easy, yeah. Yeah.
Like a normal music video. Who shot your video?
It was shot by this brother named Jacob and this dude named Jody and this guy named Diego is going to edit it. So
there we go. Shout out to Jacob, Jody, and Diego. That
so was
like
that
a band name in itself. Jacob.
So was that your first time filming a proper music video?
A proper
this,
music
video. This will be our properest music video.
Because I've seen a video, but it's kind of more of like a montage of stuff.
Ooh, he's shit.
This one will be more proper.
Huh? Somebody else made that. Oh, okay.
A fan video? Really?
That's probably unauthorized.
You've got
video.
Stans.
Wait.
Well, you put it on your webpage, so.
That's so. I love that. Wait. Okay. So this person. Do you know this person?
I don't know. I don't know which one you're talking about. It could be.
I mean, they know you apparently.
Oh yeah. We know that person.
Oh yeah. We knew. Oh yeah. Them with the face and the things.
Well, I don't know.
What?
We found.
Just
the
right
flute.
Behind me is the Frankenflute. Oh my God.
We found the flute, y'all.
Look how gorgeous she is. It looks. Show us your flute. This is cool.
Symbolic. I'll just say that.
Like a really dope fertility flute.
Yeah.
I like it. I'm a fan. That surprises no one here.
First of all, sorry. For leaving the head in the car.
Oh, no. Hey. Tragedy.
So this is just like a regular flute, the kind that you play like this. And then we just like make this head, and I just like put it on. And the cool thing is that now I have all the notes.
That's genius.
So I can play. I mean.
What?
And just like play all the notes.
Wow. That's incredible. Have you invented anything else? I feel like you're probably the kid that was like putting, like no, that's not, no, you never like mashed up anything else together?
It's like a flute if you're tired of your hands falling asleep. You just get to, yeah.
Yeah, what, it's, okay, so I'm confused about like, it's a, you said it's a charcoal and what?
It's like natural.
Beeswax.
Play-Doh.
Genius.
Like beeswax and charcoal.
Nature's Play-Doh.
Nature's Planet. Completely off the side. It's a completely side topic. You guys recorded with Adrian Quesada, which is, yeah, like people know who that is, right? No? Yeah. Okay, there we go. Ben's like the sound engineer. Yes. What was that like? And do you want to tell Austin Eastciders what that was kind of like recording with him? Because when I was reading your bio, it seemed like it was like a good kickoff point for y'all as a group.
It's really cool to have the support of guys like Adrian Quesada and Beto Martinez from Brownout, Grupo Fantasma, Money Chicha, the list goes on. So, yeah, it was really an awesome way to like kickstart the band. It was. That was our first recording experience with this group was over at Adrian. So, it's really like, you know, set the bar pretty high.
Right. Like, where else can, I mean, that's a pretty dope setup. What does a recording session look like for y'all with just the sheer number of y'all? Is it insane? Hot?
It takes a lot of coordination. Yeah, it's pretty hot. That's where the Caribbean flavor comes in.
There we go. A little sweat, a little stank. Never hurt anybody.
Stinky.
You know, that's what the pattern shirts are for. It's to distract all the sweat patterns.
Pretty much.
Just like a bad maze. I guess if you guys, you're clearly the inventor, and he's apparently the diva. Who's the messy one, the funny one, slutty one? Who's the messy, funny, slutty one?
Which Spice Girl is
Daniel.
Who?
Yeah, which Spice Girl is who?
I used to be the slutty one, but
it's like I'm a reformed slutty band member.
Evan's
the genius. He's like, no, stop it, guys.
Oh,
I just
played
the baby piano. Leave me in my
stop
fetal
it.
Piano.
Oh, God.
Anybody? Who's the funny one?
We are all super funny.
Superfónicos.
You have to be super funny to be in Superfónicos.
And super funny clothes, is that what you said? He is the genius. That was a solid pun right there. Okay. Do you guys want to go into your segment, Sir Claude?
My segment? Great. All right. So I like to go into a little segment called Claude Goes on a Tangent. I look up some details about the band, and I ask y'all some trivia questions about it, and I get to do lots of Google research, which is kind of my jam. So when I type Superfónicos into Google, it says... a thing comes up that says October 12th, Superfónicos. So I don't know if y'all know you have a holiday.
Ooh.
I don't know what that is, but...
Surprise holiday.
But I want y'all to know, like, what you're competing with holiday-wise, you know, hashtag branding. So I'm going to ask y'all some questions. The first one's multiple choice. October 12th is also the religious observation of what mundane vision of the Mother of God?
Ooh.
Is it A, Our Lady of the Breakfast Nook, B, Our Lady of the Pillar, or C, Our Lady by the Interstate?
That's not a saint.
B sounds the most logical, but let's go with C.
I like your style, because the correct answer is B, but C sounds more fun.
It does.
October 12th, Our Lady of the Pillar. I looked up the history of this day. It is as boring as it sounds.
The actual, stone pillar, like a house pillar.
I guess, she showed up next to a pillar, and they were like, yeah, we'll go with it.
Because the Our Lady of the Interstate sounds like those, the lady on the corner by my house that's like, you got a cigarette? That's that Lady of the Interstate.
Oh, I was just thinking mundane direct, wayfinding, but if you want to...
I went straight
If you want to judge...
Well, it's fine.
...the lady. Anyways, second question. Now, I usually do multiple choice. Today, I decided I'm going to venture from that, not really thinking that there were eight of you. So, you know what? We'll go with it. What are they going to do, fire me? So, October 12th is also Launch a Cookbook Day. It is a day where organizations are encouraged to compile their recipes and launch cookbooks. That's the name of the day. What are a couple recipes that would be in the Superfónicos cookbook?
Well, that's a good question.
Just a sweet potato?
Raymond eats five sweet potatoes cooking. In a sitting.
What? Raw?
Ajiaco.
You go out. Take a shovel, use your bare hands, dig up some raw sweet potatoes, and just chomp on them.
That's the recipe.
Just wherever you just go out and find sweet potatoes. They're just buried everywhere.
I wish I could, but just kind of cut them up, kind of like sweet potato fries. Put them in the oven 400 degrees, 1 hour.
Okay.
Put some cinnamon on.
Yams is his jam.
Cinnamon on a sweet. Yeah. That sounds delicious.
That shit's good.
Yeah, excellent recipe.
Stuff.
Let me get two more recipes.
Anyway.
Then you've got yourselves a cookbook.
Oh, he knows. Chicken soup?
Chicken soup.
It took us about 2.5 years to cook this stew before we decided to serve it up to
me. Oh, I like that. Like a long-term chicken soup.
Yeah.
It took 2 years to make. Wait, how long does it take to you to make chicken soup?
This chicken soup took 2.5 years. Aw.
Chicken soup for the Superfónicos soul.
Yeah.
That's it. Anybody else?
Raymond and Evan don't eat chicken.
Oh, chicken soup.
We had to cook two different stews.
It's sweet potato soup. Get with the program. Anybody have good hand-me-down recipes? Nobody makes their mom's chili? Why was chili the first thing I met?
I'm going to just throw an idea out there. When you make grilled cheese, instead of butter, use egg. And it's a savory French toast grilled cheese.
He told me this a couple weeks ago. I did it.
Mm.
Boom.
Yeah. Life hack.
It was also probably the weed, but it was good.
It was good. I didn't mean to segue that into my own bit, but put
grilled
egg
cheese.
On a grilled cheese sandwich. It's amazing.
Life hack.
So my third and final question, as Claude goes on a tangent. October 12th is International Moment of Frustration Scream Day. Now, let me unpack this. This was a holiday created by Thomas and Ruth Roy, who sell herbal supplements and also copyrighted a bunch of holidays in some sort of underwear gnome scheme, I think. Because on their website, you can book them to organize corporate events for their stupid holidays. Some of their other holidays include February 11th, Satisfied Staying Single Day. July 10th, Don't Step on a Bee Day.
Well,
my favorite, March 3rd, What If Cats and Dogs Had Opposable Thumbs Day. I don't know what you do on that. Just what if? What scares me is this just how holidays start? In 500 years, are people going to reverently be celebrating Don't Step on a Bee Day?
How often does that...
Catholics will have a whole hullabaloo about it. And
I feel like holidays are something you do because it happens, doesn't happen that often. But, how often are people stepping on bees? What's wrong with
I don't
with
know
you?
What's special about that day. Anyways,
why are the bees on the ground?
My point is Superfónicos Day on October 12th is competing with International Moment of Frustration Scream Day. So how do you celebrate Superfónicos Day?
With some frustration screams.
Ooh.
Oh, piggybacking. I like your style.
And also wondering about the opposable thumbs of cats and dogs.
Yeah.
And
not the season for it, though.
Bees are totally safe that day, too.
Totally safe. Just don't step on a bee. Yeah, maybe that's what it is. It's don't step on a bee. Protect bees.
Yeah.
But instead of just saying protect bees, they tell people don't step on bees.
Just this one day, don't step on them.
Since one freaking day, Claude. No, that's good. I like that.
All right.
How else? Anybody else got how you would celebrate Superfónicos Day?
We're going to celebrate 2 days after that at ACL on the 14th.
Ooh, ooh.
What about you? You had an answer.
It might involve some of these props.
It might involve these props.
Like this terrifying, I don't.
I like to call it the gay tiger baby.
Gay tiger baby. That's actually.
You know, he's living his truth. I like him.
It's the title of my autobiography.
I was thinking Superfónicos Day could be like a really heartwarming purge where for one day there are no borders in the world.
Mm.
And everybody just mills around.
We're totally
just
mills
on board
about.
With that.
Yeah.
That's the goal. All right. You
Again,
guys
I segued into my own thing, but whatever. It's my last
Claude
day.
Claude goes on a tangent.
Kick me out. Yeah. Claude goes on a tangent.
That's a good segment.
That
Thank
ends
you
my
very
segment.
Much.
Thank you.
Clap for Claude. Ah. Ooh, that was fun. Now we're going to be able to.
Cease clapping now.
All right. You guys want to kick into two more songs for the house here and for Facebook? You guys want to hear two more songs? Apparently, yes. All right. Let's kick it off. It's Superfónicos at Austin Eastciders, ladies and gentlemen.
This next one is partially about not having any borders. Segways.
Cruzando río y frontera, buscando firme fundación, para darle mejor vida a tu esposa y tu hija y a la próxima generación. La mochila en el hombro, de amor y esperanza, es fácil decir adiós. Las murallas al frente, pa' separar a la gente que solo causan dolor y frustración. Vuelve, vuelve volando, vuela, vuelve volando, vuela ya. Vuelve, vuelve volando, vuela, vuelve volando, vuela ya. Saliste de tu tierra, cruzando río y frontera, buscando firme fundación, para darle mejor vida a la esposa y la hija y a la próxima generación. La mochila en el hombro, de amor y esperanza, es fácil decir adiós. Las murallas al frente, pa' separar a la gente, que solo causan dolor y frustración. Vuelve, vuelve volando, vuela, vuelve volando, vuela ya. Vuelve, vuelve volando, vuela, vuelve volando, vuela ya. Oh, saliste de tu tierra buscando otra manera. Saliste de tu tierra buscando otra manera. Saliste de tu tierra buscando otra manera. Por la violencia, el hambre.
Saliste de tu tierra
y la guerra
buscando otra manera. Lleva
la mochila en el hombro
llena
de amor y esperanza. Es fácil decir adiós. Las murallas al frente va a separar a la gente que solo causan dolor y frustración. Vuelve, vuelve volando, vuela,
vuelve volando, vuela ya.
Vuelve, vuelve volando, vuela,
vuelve volando, vuela ya.
So this next one's called Suelta. It's actually the title track off our EP that comes out October 5. That's a week from Friday. So look out for it.
Suelta,
suelta,
las apariencias suelta,
suelta,
toda esa vaina suelta,
suelta,
suéltalo todo ya,
suelta,
el racismo suelta,
suelta,
la misoginia suelta,
suelta,
el machismo suelta,
suelta,
suéltalo todo ya,
que yo te digo que hay que soltar. Ay, si bien fresco tú quieres estar, ponte en talla, libra la batalla, ponte en buena onda, quiébrate en la raya, porque ah, que la verdad que va a estallar, lo que no vale pasará, lo bueno quedará, porque soltando vamos ya, óyelo mamá, suelta, que suelta, que suelta todo ya.
Suelta,
la competencia suelta,
suelta,
las apariencias suelta,
suelta,
toda esa vaina suelta,
suelta,
suéltalo todo ya.
Suelta.
La xenofobia suelta, suelta, suelta,
suelta.
Las apariencias suelta, suelta, suelta,
suelta.
Los miedos suelta, suelta, suelta,
suelta.
Suéltalo todo ya. We'll be right back. este momento pa' coger cultura, respetando la natura, óyelo, y volviendo a la cordura, sí señor, respetando la natura, repítelo, y volviendo a la cordura, sí señor, mira que hay que soltar, para agarrar hay que soltar, no aferrarse a nada. Ya tuve, así es, pa' que entienda usted, tú tienes lo que necesita para siempre estar en 10. Párate y anda, relájate, goza esta cumbia, entrégate, déjate y suéltate. La competencia suelta,
suelta.
Las apariencias sueltas,
suelta.
Toda esa vaina suelta,
suelta.
Suéltalo todo ya,
suelta.
Las religiones sueltas,
suelta.
Las banderas sueltas,
suelta.
Las patrias sueltas,
suelta.
Suéltalo todo ya.
Damn.
Thank you.
Well, shit. That was a damn good show, even if you are leaving me. What? Help. No, I'm actually really bummed. It's Claude's last show. I hate to bring it up, but it's true. He's leaving me. He's dying.
That's exactly how it's working.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's going to be no longer with us. But before we get out of here, do you have any upcoming shows?
Yeah. Well, first of all, so many great comic talent in Austin. So show up next week to see Zach Brooks, the newest co-host for Comedians Interviewing Musicians. If you just can't bear it and you need to see me again, I have a weekly show every Thursday, 8 o'clock, Hops and Grain, who are also one of our sponsors.
Holla.
Stand-up showcase called Gutbusters. I pick the comics myself, so I guarantee you it'll be funny.
No, at least be cute.
Yeah, at least, you
at
know.
At the very least.
That's what I go for. Shout out to our VIPs. I think we have one here tonight, Beth.
Oh, she's outside with the cute
puppy.
She's
out. See, she brought the dog. So, see, that's why I'm a
cat
person.
Shout out to Sebastian. And thank you so much for joining. Where are y'all from? Yeah, here?
Right here.
Bam, okay.
We were told to ask where you're from, and I thought they're probably just here, but but now we did it. Check that off our list. But
fair. Superfónicos, where can we see you next?
ACL, October 14.
Woo!
Woo!
And our EP comes out October 5th, but
there we go.
Yeah.
Our next performance is October 14th at ACL.
So your EP and then Superfónicos Day and then ACL. Like October is just Superfónicos month.
It's like your birthday.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Birth month.
Huh?
Yeah, I was gonna say they played Formula One.
Are y'all performing at Formula One? Oh, wow.
We're racing, actually.
Racing. Oh, that's perfect. Thank you so much. We're really excited. We'd like to give a shout out to our sponsors. We mentioned Hops and Grains. We also have Nine Band Whiskey and New Standard Manufacturing. If you need merch, check them out. They're super lovely. Softest t-shirts alive.
Mm-hmm.
And again, big round of applause for Austin Eastciders for always having us. You guys are so great. Bartender's always really lovely. Super cool. Appreciate you guys so much. And as well as our patrons, thank you so much for supporting us. For as little as a dollar a month, you can help starving artists like us. Preview beautiful artists who are really good and actually talented.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, it's really fun. Again, thank you so much for being my co-host, Claude. I love you.
It's been a blast.
I'm going to miss you terribly. Next week, we have Zach Brooks. He's somewhere around here. I don't know. He probably left.
I don't think he's
in the back.
Oh, there he is.
Hi,
hey.
Zach. He's going to be here next week. Not here. We're going to be at the Velveeta Room with Ray Prim. It's going to be a dope show. So you should totally come to that.
Sounds amazing.
It's going to be fun. The Velveeta Room, back in the stomping grounds, comedy-wise. It's going to be fun. And last but not least, we're going to cut the Facebook feed, so buy the internet. But the rest of the house here gets a whole other song from Superfónicos. So if you guys want to stick around, yes. Thank you so much, Facebook. We love you. Good night.
You.
Give it up again, Austin Eastciders, for Superfónicos. We love you. Good night.
Okay, head over to CIMP.live and get your bonus videos, photos, merch, and more. And remember to give the podcast a 5-star rating. Every rating helps these artists get discovered by new fans. You can find all the full videos and past podcasts at musicfirsthand.live. Thanks for listening. See you next time.